मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज इन हिस्ट्री एंड दैट इज वेयर व्हेन एंड हाउ वील बी टॉकिंग अबाउट, राइट, हाउ ब्रिटिशर्स हैव एस्टैब्लिश्ड देमसेल्व्स इन इंडिया एंड हाउ यू नो ब्रिटिशर्स जस्ट डिडंट कोलोनाइज इंडिया बट इवन देयर यू नो देयर कमिंग टू इंडिया brought a lot of cultural changes in India as well. There was a mixing of culture, mixing of the Indian culture and the Western culture, right? There was a clash between the traditions we had followed for so long and the traditions which they follow. What kind of changes, positive and negative, had occurred in India with the coming of the Britishers? Now in India, the modern period begins with the establishment of British rule under the East India Company. Finally, when Britishers have proved their dominance in India, right, and India had gone under a colonial rule of 200 years. So a lot of changes took place, a lot of developments took place. Developments maybe for only for the benefits of the Britishers, development of railways, right, not for Indians, for making transport easier, for making trading easier, right. Britishers had developed railways in India for their own benefit. They have developed a lot of hill stations, not for we Indians, but for themselves, because they wanted a home-like environment. Because European countries are generally cold, right? And since in hill stations are the perfect, since hill stations have the perfect cold climates, so they had developed, you know, hill stations like Dalhousie, like Mussoorie, like Shimla, right? So with the establishment of British rule, several major changes and developments took place in the political, economic, social and cultural life of India. Major developments. With the coming of the British, new systems of administration, laws and revenue collection were introduced in India, right? Like a lot of changes means different laws were imposed by the Britishers on Indian people. There was different how taxes will be collected and which government body will look over tax collection and what kind of taxes and taxes on what things will be imposed by the Britishers on Indians and how India will be administered under the British rule. The purpose of the British rule was to colonize India, to control Indian market and to drain away wealth from India. And they were successful in that also, right? They have took over the control of the major governmental bodies. They have developed laws which favored only Britishers and which were not in favor of Indians. And the way they were collecting revenues from Indian people, right? The way they were draining away all the resources of the India, right? is a perfect example of the brutal colonization from the British end. British rule led to the exploitation of the peasants, artisans and craftsmen and ruined the handicraft industry of India. How have they ruined the handicraft industry of India? By bringing machine-made goods in India. By bringing cheap machine-made goods in India, Britishers have completely ruined the handicraft industry of India, right? They have brought cheaper, machine-made goods in India, and that is why the handicrafts industries were completely destroyed. How come peasants and artisans? Peasants were destroyed because a lot of taxes were imposed on the peasants, right? The zamindari system and a lot of other systems were there through which Britishers were exploiting the peasants. Naturally, the Indians protested against this colonial oppression, leading to sporadic incidents of localized violence and finally, the mass revolt of 1857. True, Indians were not happy with this kind of rule because this country belonged to Indian. The administration was there. You know, your Indians should have been the head, the leaders of that administration. If laws were being imposed, then those laws should have been in favor of Indians. Revenue collection, if you're doing the revenue collection, right? That revenue collection, that tax, would tax money would have been used in the development of the people. But instead of developing the Indian, instead of bringing changes in the life of Indians, the money which they collected from revenue was taken back to the Britain in the Queen's account, right? So the purpose was not, the purpose of colonizing India was to completely exploit the resources of India. And that is why Indians revolted against this kind of revolt. Locally also, and even a mass revolt took place in 1857, right? Led by Mangal Pandey and many other leaders. Now, major development, slide 2. Naturally, the Indians protested against this kind of oppression, leading to sporadic incidents of localized violence and finally the mass revolt in 1857. During the British rule, India witnessed numerous social and cultural changes. The Western education and its far-reaching impact left the utmost mark on the intelligentsia, means the intellectual class of any society, the high class people. They were very much attracted towards the Western education, right? They were very much, you know, impressed with this English culture. And that is why they even started promoting the Western culture and Western education in India. During the British rule, a number of social legislations were passed to prevent child marriage, sati and female infanticide. This was the positive thing which they had done. They had banned sati, they had banned female infanticide, and they prevented child marriage. Laws were passed to improve the condition of the widows and impart education to women. Indian reformers led to major protest against the social evil of caste system. So yes, certain positive points were there. They had developed certain policies which, you know, worked in favor of women's and widows, right? They started imparting education to women as well. So this was few positive things which they had done, right? Apart from exploiting the resources of India, this was something positive which came out from the British people. Banning of sati, banning of child marriage, banning of female infanticide. Now class, what you will do is, this was just a brief introduction of this chapter, right? This was just an introduction of what we are going to study in next lecture. So what you people will do is, you will just go through the chapter once. I'll provide you the PDF of this chapter. Read it thoroughly, as it will help you understand the basic points of this chapter. Thank you.